And Bruce doesn't even know where Harrisburg is. He doesn't. This guy, I mean, he went to New York and they threw him around like a rag doll. I love him. When I watch him come in second to Kasich, I just love it.
Third.
It's so cool. Oh, look, we're all filled up back there. I hope you people in the back, are you okay? I feel bad for people. They got to hear about 2% of what we've been talking about. But look. So, we are going to get all of these things done. You've got to get out in front. You've really got to put up in. You've got to get your friends. You've got to get everybody. Tuesday, you know, a few days. It's amazing how time flies. It feels like I went to New York yesterday. It's already like 3 days. And I'll tell you what, it really does. They really know me well in New York. And this is serious. They know me well. What really is nice is the people that really know me. I mean, I'm doing buildings here, doing buildings. I employ lots of people. The people that know the person, when they vote for the person, and you get even 10 points higher than the polls were saying you were going to get, that means they love you. I get 61. Remember, they were all saying, the great Jeffrey Lord will tell you this, but they were all saying, Jeffrey, if he can break 50, it'll be a great victory. Is that right? But breaking 60, nobody, I got 61, more than 61. So here's the start. And almost all of the delegates.
Believe me.
You got to go out and vote on Tuesday. Because we have a movement going on. We have a movement that's been on the cover of Time magazine many times over the last number of months. We have a movement that everybody in the world is talking about. We have a movement of millions and millions of people. You know, the Republican Party, not known necessarily as the hottest thing in the world, is now one of the hottest things in the world.
Yeah.
One of the hottest things in the world. You know, the Republican Party, 4 years ago, Mitt Romney ran, and he choked. He choked. You should have won that election.
Yeah.
That election was easier than this election, but don't worry about it. But you should have won that. And John McCain ran, and it was a tough one because of the economy. But John ran, and I backed him, and I lost. Mitt Romney ran, and I backed him, and he lost. And then I said to my wife, you know what? This time, I'm going to do it myself. Yeah. So, you're going to remember this night. You're going to remember this beautiful evening. Very nice. Other than I don't like the scenery of empty factories all over the place, okay? But you're going to remember this beautiful evening. More importantly, on Tuesday, you're going to remember going to the voter's booth. You're going to cast the most important vote of your life.
Yeah.
You're going to vote for Trump. And now, if you ever hear these politicians, I mean, you know, they're just politicians, when they say, please, go out and vote. Even if you're not voting for me, vote for my opponent. It's so important as an American exercise for you to go out and vote. I'm not saying that. If you're going to vote for anybody else other than me, do not go out and vote.
Yeah!
I don't want anybody, but I don't think there's too many people in this room, but is there anybody in the room that's going to vote for other than Trump? I told you about Bill O'Reilly, what he said. I told you about Time magazine. I told you about everything. It's the hottest thing happening. We're up 70% from 4 years ago. The Democrats are down 35%. In other words, Hillary and Bernie are down 35% from 4 years ago. We are up more than 70% in votes. All right?
Woo!
And by the way, this is the hottest event all over the world we're talking about. What's happened to the Republican Party? And then you have these people, the bosses of the party, the establishment, they don't like Trump. And you know, they don't like me because they can't take care of me because I'm not taking their money. I just want I want to bring back our jobs. I want to take care of our military. I want to do what's right for our country. We got to save our country. So here's the story. Great night. You're going to go on Tuesday, you're going to vote. You're going to get all your friends, everybody that can vote. Don't forget, the other side votes, and who the hell knows if they're even allowed to vote.
Yeah.
You're going to get every single person you know that can vote, go out of it. You're going to say it was the most important vote you've ever cast. You're going to look back. You're going to look back in 4 years, in 20 years, in 30 years. You're going to say, that was the greatest vote that I ever cast. Because when Donald Trump became president of the United States, our country started winning again.
Yeah!
We don't win. We don't win with our military. We can't be nicest. We don't win with our vets. We don't take care of them. We don't win with education. Common Core is a disaster, which, by the way, we're ending and we're bringing education. We don't win with healthcare. And as you know, Obamacare, our premiums go 25, 35, 45% up. We're not going. It's ended. It's over. We're going to have great healthcare.
Yeah.
We don't win at the borders. We don't win at trade. Here's what's going to happen, folks. And you better get used to it. We're going to start winning again. We're going to win with our military. We're going to knock the hell out of ISIS. We're going to win with our vets. We're going to take care of our vets. We're going to win on the border. We're going to have a real border. We're going to have a great border. We're going to have a border where people come into our country, but they can only come into our country legally. We're going to bring in education. We're getting rid of Common Core. We're bringing our education local. We're going to win with health care. We're going to win with trade. We're going to make the greatest trade deals this country has ever made. And we're going to bring jobs back to Harrisburg and to Pennsylvania and to every other state in the world.
Thank you!
We're going to have apple products made in the United States instead of made in China.
Thank you.
We're going to stop their manipulation of currency. We're going to stop their devaluation of currency. We're going to have products like from Apple starting to be made in our great country again.
Yeah.
So we're going to start winning again. We're going to start as enthusiasts. We're going to win so much, folks. Some of you won't be able to take it because you're not used to it. We're going to win at every level. And I have fun with this, and I have to say it. Should I say it? We are going to win, win, win. We're going to win so much, and you're going to say, Mr. President, please, sir,